So let's talk about automatic login. Let me show you how to use it, more importantly how to disable it, and why you should have it disabled. You should absolutely not be using automatic login. A lot of people don't want to have to enter a password every time they sit down at their Mac. And I can understand, it's kind of annoying, and especially if you have a Mac that's on a desktop, it's sitting in your house, it's not a laptop, you're not moving it around, you think I should just be able to turn it on or hit the space bar and start working. But a password protects your Mac. So let's go and look at it first. In System Preferences, there are two places where you talk about automatic login. First is in Users and Groups. You go in there and you go to Login Items here. And you can see automatic login, and I've got it turned off. In order to work with it, I need to authenticate. So I'll click here. And you can see I could set automatic login for one of the users on this Mac. I'm going to leave it to off, but even if I switched it to on, I could actually turn it off in a separate space by going back up to the main level System Preferences, going to Security and Privacy, and then under General you see Disable Automatic Login. So that's checked because I have it off. But even if I had it on, if I had it set to a user, checking this box would then turn it off. So there's two ways to turn it off. If you want to turn it on, you would have to uncheck this. You would have to go over back to where I was before and set a user to be the one for automatic login. But you shouldn't do that. Obviously, if you have a MacBook and you ever take it out of your house, the reasons are obvious. It's easy for somebody to swipe it, and then they have access to everything. They can check your email. They can do everything that's on your Mac because they don't need to log in. But even if it's in your house or in your workplace and nobody's supposed to have access to it, well, you know, things happen. There are break-ins. There are, you know, ways people get access to your stuff. And, you know, that one occasion where somebody actually does get access to it, they can get to everything, which could be way more valuable than what's actually in your house. It's so important. I know it takes you a few seconds to log in. And actually, if you're doing it on a regular basis, and I probably have to log into my Mac a couple dozen times a day, it gets real quick. You enter that password, it's fast. Of course, if you have a MacBook Pro with the Touch ID, it's even faster. But even if you enter the password, it's super fast. It takes me a second just for my fingers to go over that password. So once you get used to it, it's very quick. It's kind of like putting on a seatbelt when you get in a car, right? I mean, that takes a second to do, and you have to do it every time you get into a car and take it off every time you get out. But you still do it because you know that's safer. It's the same thing here. You should absolutely be using a password and not be using automatic login. Now, there is a way to alleviate things a little bit, that you can set this require password and you can set it to a time here. So just having it set to 5 minutes can actually cut out a lot of your logins. So for instance, say you're in your office, you're working, and your Mac goes to sleep. Now you think, oh great, I have to enter my password again. But if you have it set to 5 seconds, 1 minute, 5 minutes, then you know you actually can press the space bar when you see that happen and you won't have to log in again. Yet it's still providing most of those protections because chances are nobody's going to break into your house within 5 minutes of you getting up from your computer, right? I mean, it's probably going to take you 5 minutes just to get out of the house, let alone for something bad to happen. So setting it to something like 5 minutes, maybe even 15, is a way to alleviate the issue. But anything longer than that, you're entering kind of a danger zone, and I wouldn't go there. You also want to make sure this item is actually checked, because without it checked, that means if you walk away from your Mac, it won't automatically log you out. You have to manually log yourself out. You want it to automatically log you out so that you don't have to worry about doing that. Think of it this way. When you get into a car, you have to put your seatbelt on. A little bit of an inconvenience, but it's definitely worth it for safety. But it's also inconvenient, then you have to take your seatbelt off to get out of the car. Well, the great thing is, with your Mac, you don't have to take your seatbelt off. It's done automatically for you. You just have to worry about putting it on, entering the password, when you first start using your Mac. So I can't stress enough how important it is that you do not use automatic login. It's just part of using a computer today. It's like wearing a seatbelt, wearing a bike helmet, not giving your social security number to strangers. It's just one of those things that you need to do. You have to enter a password when you start up or wake up your Mac every time.